Hey, what's up everybody? Jordan Krakey coming back to you with a couple hitting videos. Hey, I wanted to touch base a little bit after several weeks of lessons and getting numerous amounts of kids in here to hit and have a little fun. I wanna go over the three biggest mistakes that I'm seeing, and they're very basic, okay? If we start out doing these three things wrong early on in youth hitters, it's just gonna develop bad habits for the rest of their career, all right? So we need to make sure we nip these in the butt before we get going, we get into habits, just like tying our shoes and all that stuff. The main thing here, we need to work on this stuff at home, okay? I've been seeing a lot of people and repeat customers, all right? And I'm doing this all for free, so my time is precious right now. So make sure you're doing these things at home. When I come here and I teach you, I make all of my kids repeat what we worked on before and after, especially after three or four times, so that they understand that they need to go home and work on these things themselves, okay? So make sure you're working on this with your kids, coaches, make sure you're asking them what they've been working on so that we can develop these bad habits and get them into good habits, all right? So real quick, just to touch on things, this has came up numerous times, all right? So this is gonna develop a bad long swing, all right? So it's the big knuckles, little knuckles, okay? Look at this. All right, I get a lot of hitters that come in with their big knuckles lined up, all right? That's these big knuckles here, okay? The big knuckles are lined up, all right? You get tight wrist, tight arms to where we only can have a long swing. A slow, long swing, okay? So if your big knuckles are lined up, it's wrong, okay? You need to line up the little knuckles, guys, all right? You need to get the bat in your fingertips, okay? And parents, coaches, if you take your finger, all right, and tell them to grab it with their palm, you can pull the finger right out. If you put that finger in your fingertips and you try to pull it out, you can't. There's a much stronger grip there. Okay, so we need to make sure that we're getting our little knuckles lined up so that we have this little wrist flex right here, okay, so that we can whip the bat through the zone, all right? We need to be able to go here to whip, okay? It's very important, here to whip, okay? Whip, not a wrist locked in, tight, long swing. Okay, that's the number one mistake I'm seeing in a lot of kids. Number two mistake, all right, is where your feet, where your weight distribution is in your feet, okay? This is also extremely important, all right? I get most hitters, most youth hitters in here with all of their weight on their heels, okay? I don't know if you can see it from that angle, but if you look here, it looks like there's a metal pole running down my Achilles tendon into the ground. We don't want our weight, look. We don't want our weight on our heels. All that's gonna allow us to do is spin and rotate, okay? If we spin and rotate, we're getting one result. A swing and a miss, or a ground ball to shortstop. I ain't getting nobody anywhere, all right? We need to make sure we get that weight on the balls of our feet, okay? We gotta make sure we're getting the weight here. On the inside balls of our feet. We wanna make sure that when we set up the hit, we're in that athletic position. And parents, if you wanna work on this with your kids, tell them to do defensive slides like in basketball. All right, that's gonna force them to get on the right weight on their feet, on the inside part of their feet, on the balls of their feet. All right, so we want the weight here and here on the inside part of our knees and our feet, with the weight on the balls of our feet, okay? See the difference, all right? Even our posture's better. Now our posture, our chest, all right, our back is a little bit bent to where we're over top of the plate so we can see the strike zone a little better versus weight on our heels. We're away from the strike zone, our eyes are away from the strike zone, everything's back on our heels and we can't even see strikes, okay? It's just like lining up a putt, all right? If you're way away from your putt like this, what's the chances of us making that putt or even seeing the correct line? Not good at all, right? You gotta get up in there, you gotta get the right posture, okay? So start taking those things and starting out with your kid and making sure they got the right setup before we even start swinging. Okay, that's a lot of the corrections early on in a lot of my drills. And one thing to do, and a lot of kids then, you know, they'll get up way up on their tiptoes like that. That's not the deal here. Basically, what you want to do is if you got a little sheet of cardboard, slip it behind their heels. Okay, that's what I do. Slip a plate, all right, or a little piece of cardboard behind their heels so that their heels are sliver off the ground so that we get the weight on the right part of our feet. Okay. The last thing is the load. Okay, we're missing steps in the swing. I did an earlier video on the four or five steps of a swing. A lot of kids are missing out on the most important step, and that's the load. Okay, if we don't load, guys, we're never going to hit a ball in the infield. Okay, we need to make sure that we're loading. All right, so by a load I mean a slingshot. So slingshot hands. That's how I explain it. Okay, think of a slingshot. Okay, I got a slingshot here, I got a rock. If I don't take that slingshot back, how far is the rock going? It's not going very far. If I take that slingshot back to here, it's like a band, right? When I let that band go, pow, there goes the rock. Okay, so if we're getting kids that are just launching from here, you're getting pitter-patter little swings, all right? But if we get some slingshot hands involved, all right, look at that, you get a lot of pop. All right, I barely even did anything. All right, that's one part of the load. Second part of the load is we got to start taking and getting some weight back in this hip so we can stay behind the baseball. Watch Fernando Tatis Jr. This guy hits absolute nukes, oppo tacos to right field because he gets all his weight loaded up in this back hip and hits behind the baseball, okay? He watches the baseball get off his bat and take off on an airplane flight to right field, all right? We need to make sure that we are loading somehow or another. Now, when you load, I'm not talking about a huge body weight change distribution to your right, to the back side. Now our mind wants to overcorrect and we come way forward. I'm talking about shifting weight into your back butt cheek, into your hip, into your back front knee, okay? If you do that with a little slingshot hands, look at that, all right? You're in a great position to hit. So what we're doing here is we're pushing down with this foot here, and then when our gas pedal lands, boom, we drive into that front side. This weight distribution right here is slingshot, okay? Boom, we get all that weight coming into this front side and hit against it. That's where we get the torque, okay? So one thing that goes along with the load, and you parents and your coaches have got to work on this. If you're doing flips, if you're doing BP with your kids, you need to throw them a couple and then stop, all right? Don't tell them when you're gonna stop, all right? So maybe when you're doing flips, just hold it one time. The kid needs to realize what it feels like to stride and pause, okay? If your kid is loading, if he's doing everything great, but he's not stepping with that gas pedal ready to go, and he's landing with his full weight on his front foot, your swing's flawed, okay? We got our hands back, but we got no weight to hit, okay? So you need to make sure that you're stopping in between loads, in between swings, so that you can see that your kid has his weight back, all right? He's landing to the inside part of his toe, all right? So that we can then, look, this is the gas pedal. I teach this all the time to kids. You land here, okay? You land here, when that heel goes to touch the ground, your hands, your back hip, all your stored energy comes forward, that heel hits the ground, and that's your gas pedal to swing, okay? Very important. Three common mistakes, okay? Let's line the little knuckles up, okay? So that you can get some good wrist whip, okay? Number two, let's get the weight on the inside part of our feet, all right? Onto our balls of our feet like we're doing defensive slides, like we're playing defense in basketball, all right? Like we're a running back or a receiver in football, whatever you wanna compare it to. And then number three, let's make sure we incorporate some slingshot hands, all right? Again, on the slingshot hands, I'm talking hands, I'm not talking shoulders. A lot of kids will all of a sudden start twisting in. Now our head gets away, we gotta wrap back around, that's wrong. All right, let's work on slingshot hands, getting our hands back, but also incorporating a little bit of weight in this back hip, inside knee, all right? And then basically we're landing to our front toe, our front ball of our feet, so that we can get that gas pedal heel hitting the ground and letting the rest of our swing follow through, okay? Three common mistakes right there with some tips on how to correct that. I hope everybody's doing well. Summer heat, stay cool, get in the pool. Hey, share, subscribe. Let's try to get this going a little bit, huh? Thanks a lot, Jordan Krakey.